Like I had just mentioned at the end of the previous tutorial video, we have some good progress going here. I can take my magnifying tool, zoom out to the left, hold my space bar. I got a pretty good start going here. I don't want to lose that. Okay, so what I'm going to do is go to File menu, Save a Copy. The reason why you want to go to Save a Copy is it lets you change your format to Photoshop. The Photoshop format preserves your layers. Okay, so anything you do for this class, you're going to call it your last name, then your first name, and then a word or two describing what the file is. Coloring line art. As long as it says .psd, Photoshop document, you will be able to keep your layers and pick up where you left off. So I'm going to click Save. You might see a big gray box that says compatibility, something like that. Just click OK. Maximize compatibility. You'll be fine. But now you have a Photoshop file on your desktop. So here's the most important thing. Your Photoshop file is out on your desktop. This is still the original JPEG. It's not going to keep these layers. Okay, so I'm going to close this by hitting the X. I'm not going to save this one right here. I will go to File and Open. And on my desktop, there's my Photoshop file. The Photoshop file with the layers so I can pick up where I left off. That is really, really important. Save your progress, close it, and then reopen it from your desktop. You have to remember that or you will really mess up your progress here. Okay, so you can see it right up there. Nielsen, Chris, coloringlineart.psd. There's my layers. In the next video, I'm going to show you how we can go out and grab actual photos to incorporate into this as another use for texture. So I'll see you in a minute.